Greetings, I am the cartoon hero. You know, some people think, even today, that cartoons are a medium just for kids. But thankfully that mindset seems to be dying out. Which is good, because I've been a believer for a long time that animation is just another form of storytelling. And not necessarily one just meant to teach lessons to kids. And hopefully with this show I've helped to spotlight at least a few animated pieces that I feel aren't as watched as often as they should be. And then you come to movies like this. There are certain movies like Grave of the Fireflies or Afro Samurai that are undeniably good movies, when you take away the whole idea that Grave of the Fireflies was meant to shame overprivileged Japanese kids, but some people might have trouble watching them. Again, not because they're bad, but because the story was meant to unsettle you. In short, if you feel uncomfortable while you're watching them, that's not a bug. It's a feature. There's no problem with this in itself. Art is meant to convey all types of emotions, after all. But it's for this reason that I have to insert a caveat when I recommend these shows. That they might not be for everyone, even if I do appreciate them as good works of art. On that note, we have Ringing Bell. This 1978 movie was another Patreon request, and one that people have asked me to review before. And it's also one of those movies that I just mentioned. A movie that tells a story well, but the story itself paints a pretty grim picture of the nature of evil and revenge. And it stars a cute little lamb! And it's one of the darkest anime I've ever seen. And you'll see why as we finally watch Ringing Bell.
Ask if you can hear the sound of my voice through the cold hard ground. I lost a while searching for you. I scream into the dark. If the world we're living in has a single soul that you love, if it holds a shred of meaning, well then it's worth every fight. And when all that we know comes to push and shove, then we will pierce the heavens. The colors you see are new.
The movie opens on a farm with our protagonist Chirin, a rambunctious little lamb who always wears a bell around his neck so his mother can find him. But all is not peaceful on this farm, and Chirin's mom informs him that a monstrous wolf lives nearby, who loves to eat sheep. Unfortunately, Chirin doesn't know what to do when the wolf shows up, and his mother ends up throwing herself in the wolf's way to save him, getting killed in the process. Okay, I hate to make fun of this, but sometimes a movie just demands that you show a clip.
Bambi's mom, she's...
But because Chirin is too young to understand why the wolf killed his mother, he follows the wolf into the mountains where he lives, and challenges him to a fight. He loses, despite the wolf obviously going easy on him, but he keeps coming back, thinking that the only way to beat the wolf is to become strong like him. And surprisingly enough, the wolf, despite fully admitting that one day he'll kill him, agrees to train the lamb. I think the movie's trying to say that he does this because he wants to teach the lamb how the world really works, but really I think he does it for the same reason that Hawkeye agreed to train Zorro so he can beat him one day. And that reason is because... I don't know. Years pass, and eventually Chirin grows stronger and stronger, becoming a huge beast of a ram. And this is one thing I don't get. Instead of referring to the wolf as his master, he calls him his father.
Living on this mountain has changed the way I think about life. And about you. For now I think of you as a father.
Calling him his master I would get. He's the one who trained him. But his father? He killed your mother! Why the hell would you form a fatherly connection with this guy? Anyway, because Chirin apparently looks up to the wolf now, he takes him to do what wolves would do. Attack the farm. Here's here's a fun bit of trivia for you. I'm not exactly as well-versed with Japanese voice actors or seiyu as I probably should be, but I do know that in the original Japanese version of this movie, the adult version of Tiren is played by Akira Kamiya. He was a pretty prolific voice actor for a while, especially during the 80s. But there's one role in particular that you might know him for.
Omae wa mou shindeiru.
That's right. The same guy who played Kenshiro in Fist of the North Star is also the voice of the world's deadliest sheep. Well, in the Japanese version at least. But then Chirin sees that a mother lamb is trying desperately to protect her son, much as his mother protected him. And finally sees that, hey, maybe doing this is wrong! Which further begs the question of why he did it in the first place. But in desperation, he attacks the wolf, finally goring him.
You have learned well. To turn up like this is the fate of every wolf. I always knew it would be like this. That I would die in some field at the hands of someone stronger. But I'm glad that the one who did it was you, Chirin.
But there will be no happy ending for Chirin. He finds that after seeing the atrocities he committed, the sheep see him as a monster, just like the wolf. And thus, there is nowhere left for Chirin to go but to the mountains where he met the wolf. But since the wolf is no longer there, well, we're left to assume that Chirin froze to death.
The snow fell for days without letting up, covering the ground with a smooth white blanket. Whatever happened on that mountain, whatever happened in the meadow, was covered up without a trace to remind those who had witnessed it. And later, some claimed to have remembered Chirin as a lamb. Others said he was a spirit from the mountain. But they were too wrapped up with their own lives to worry about it for long. And one night, during a terrible blizzard, the gentle sound of a bell was heard. But the sheep in the meadow never saw Chirin again.
Yeah, I'm not gonna lie, Ringing Bell is a good movie, but damn is it hard to watch. For the time, the animation looks quite good. And at its core, the message is very basic. It's about how revenge is the most worthless of causes. And it illustrates that effectively and downright brutally for a movie that, I shit you not, was originally rated G. But it's not a perfect film. Chirin's arc starts off as sympathetic, but why does he end up blindly following everything the wolf does? Yeah, I know it goes with the movie's message, but from a character standpoint, why would he do this? He started training with the wolf because he killed his mother. So why then would he go along with what he says to the point where he calls the wolf his father? And the movie is weirdly short, too, only clocking in at about 45 minutes. Probably because it was originally shown as a double feature with another movie, The Mouse and His Child, which I might get to one of these days. In the end, Ringing Bell is an enjoyable film if you're looking for a kid's movie that has major balls, but the story could use a bit of work. Anyway, I'm the Cartoon Hero, and here's hoping you enjoyed the request, Julia.
To tell.